With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
The method of electrical images is used to solve the electrostatic problems where charge distribution is not specified completely. The method consists of replacement of given charge distribution by a simplified charge distribution or a single point charge or a number of point charges provided the original boundary conditions are still satisfied. For example, consider a system containing a point charge Q placed at a distance d from an infinite conducting plane. The boundary conditions are potential is 0 at infinity, potential is 0 at each point on the conducting plane. If we replace the conducting plane by a point charge placed at a distance d opposite to conducting plane, the charge minus Q is called the electrical image. Now system consists of two charge plus Q and minus Q at separation 2D. If charge plus Q moves to a distance Y from the boundary of conducting plane, the electrical image minus Q also moves to the same Y from the boundary of conducting plane, so that the new distance between plus Q and minus Q is 2Y. So what they are basically telling us about is that sometimes when it is when the exact distribution of charge is not given, what we can do is we can simplify the problem by assuming a virtual charge similar to how we draw a mirror image. So just like a mirror, if there is an object O here, its image is simply an image I. If object O is at a distance of d, then I will also be at a distance of d from the mirror. So in cases of virtual charges also, we can do that. We can assume a charge with equal magnitude but opposite nature at the same distance from a plane that we are considering, just like we do in the mirrors. So if I have a charge plus Q at a distance d from a conducting plane, so I can consider its virtual image minus Q charge at a distance d from the same conducting plane. Now what they are asking is the work done in carrying charge Q from distance d to distance y from earthed conducting plane is. So let's say this is your charge plus Q and this is your conducting plane. So by the method that they have suggested in the paragraph, what I can do is I can assume a charge minus Q here, and if initially this was at distance d, so this minus Q will also be at a distance d. So now, after that, what they have done is they have changed this position. So they have moved this charge Q from a distance d to a distance y. So this charge minus Q will also move from a distance d to a distance y. Now the work done in this process WD will be equal to final potential PF minus initial potential. What is the final potential? The final potential of these two charges will be the charges QQ divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and the distance between the two, which will be 2y, minus initial potential will be once again qq divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into the distance between the two, that is 2d, which is equal to q square upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2y minus q square upon 4 pi epsilon naught 2d. So I can take q square 4 pi epsilon naught common, so I get Q square 4 pi epsilon naught, and 1 by 2 can also be taken common. 1 by y minus 1 by d. So the work done in moving the charge from a distance d to y will be q square by 4 pi epsilon naught 1 by 2 into 1 by y minus 1 by d. That is option number b.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubtnet app today.